If we are a child of God, of course, we, although we feel it or not, don't depend on your feelings. You have the Holy Spirit. But don't be satisfied with that. It is just like a, you know, cup of water. It is the, we all drink water. You know, one cup of water won't be enough. One cup of water is enough for some time. But after that, we need more water to drink. Like that, the Holy Spirit is like, the Holy Spirit, when we have become born again, the measure of the Holy Spirit is like a cup of water. When I say the measure of the Holy Spirit, many people will disagree to me and say that, oh, Holy Spirit is a person. How can you say the measure of the Holy Spirit? I am not saying in that sense, but what I want to point out to you is that Bible itself says about Holy Spirit, Spirit beyond measure. You know, John's Gospel, chapter 3, verse 34. So from that, I understand that we can say Holy Spirit without measure, and in a, the measure of the Spirit, in that sense we can say, although he is a person, here in the Holy Spirit inspired John the Apostle to write like this in John 3:34, which says, for he whom God has sent speaks the word of God, for he gives the Spirit without measure. So there, that word measure is mentioned over there. And also in 1 John 4:13 also, we read that, what to say, 1 John 4:13. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he was given us of his Spirit. You know, that of, in Malayalam it is not that clear. Atmavine thannathinal naam arayunnu, it says in Malayalam. But in English it says in NASB, the most literal translation, he has given us, he has given us his Spirit, but he was given us of his Spirit. That of, that word is, in Greek is ek, out of, from. That is the meaning of that ek, that Greek word used over there. So he was given us, of course he has given us the Holy Spirit, and we can say he has given us of the Holy Spirit. That means a measure of the Holy Spirit, a measure of the anointing of the Holy Spirit. And also we read that verse in Luke 11:13, which says about the, where Jesus says about, Jesus says the parable. Jesus teaches disciples how to pray, Luke 11, in the first initial verses. Then 5 onwards, Jesus says a parable, and a parable about that friend which goes to his neighbor's house to get bread for his friend who has come home, Luke 11 parable. And then verse 13, Jesus says, before verse 13 itself, Jesus says, ask and it shall be given to you. Luke 11, yeah, verse 10, 9 also, ask and it will be given to you, seek and you will find, knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, everyone who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened. And there it says, it says in verse 13, if you then being evil know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? How much more he will give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him? There, actually it is the children who is asking. That means those who are already born again, they have the Holy Spirit, and they are giving, they are asking the Father for more of the Holy Spirit. So although Holy Spirit is a person, we can say more of the Holy Spirit. There is nothing wrong in that, even theologically. That is what we just saw from the scriptures. So what I am saying is that we have to be born of the Holy Spirit. Then the second level is, that born of the Holy Spirit, we can say it's the outer court experience. Then the holy place experience of being filled with the Holy Spirit. And when we are being continually filled and led by the promptings of the Holy Spirit, that is the most holy place.